everyone, it's Cheryl from Teaching 2 and 3-Year-Olds. I recently got an email from a reader who wanted to know how I handle art with our 2 and 3-Year-Olds. She has 16 children in her class, and she was trying to do it all at once, having 5 children at 3 different tables, and she said it was overwhelming. And I can imagine that would be very overwhelming. And so I thought I would share how we handle art in our classroom. With both my 2 and 3-year-old classes, I offer art during our free choice center time. So we have all our centers set up, science, blocks, dramatic play, etc. And there's also a table for art. And I have all the materials out so they can walk up and do the art activity. Now, I do try to limit it to 4 at a time because the table is not very big, and if we get too many children in that space at the same time, it gets very confusing. That's probably one of the only centers that I do manage how many children are there. And to be honest, they often can figure it out themselves. They walk up, they see it's crowded, and I just reassure them that I'll call them over when there's a spot. Now, with our 2-year-olds, we have this pocket of time towards the very end of our morning where we just needed something else to do. And so last year I decided to offer a second art activity, and it still was optional. They could do something else or come over to the art table. Well, they all wanted to be there together. That's how 2-year-olds tend to be. And since this class only has 10 children and we have a big table where all 10 children can sit, they can sit at it, it works. It would not work with our 16 3-year-olds. But with the 10 2-year-olds, it's manageable. So I do have a second art activity where all the children participate. Now again, if a child didn't want to, they wouldn't have to. But for whatever reason, our 2-year-olds just want to be there together. They feel like they're missing out if they're not part of it. So I then, in that case, have the art activity set up, a spot for each child at the table, and I have it ready before they sit down. Because if you call 2-year-olds to a table and there's nothing set up yet, it's an invitation for chaos. They don't want to wait, they get frustrated, and then you lose them. So a little tip is to have at least part of the activity ready to go, and then as they sit down, you give them the rest of the pieces. And so another tip I want to share is, and I have mentioned over and over again, is try to make your art as process art as possible. Because the more teacher-directed your art activity is, the more you have to be standing there watching how they're doing it. Whereas if it's process art, open-ended art, you're giving them the materials and they are putting them where they want to as they're creating. It's a lot easier on you as the teacher, and it is a lot more fun for the children. So that's the other thing that I suspect a lot of teachers, when they're getting frustrated with art, is that they're trying to do a craft that they have a specific way that they want it to be, and the children don't have the patience to go follow all the way through with it. They don't have the attention span, or they just plain old don't want to do it the way you want them to do it. So process art as much as you possibly can, and try to have it be during your center's time when your children can just come up when they want to and participate in the art activity. Thanks for watching.